Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this video, I will show you how to turn an image into an interesting picture using the part photo, part sketch method. I learned this method from a web tutorial by Scrappy Irene at oscraps.com. A link to it is in the description. Several examples are also included there of results that others had using this method. But as far as I know, no one has made a video of the tutorial. The method I use in this video is essentially the same. However, I threw a few twists in, such as the sponge background wash and the tea stain texture. On the first example picture, I added smart blur and poster edges to the composite layer. The image I started out with is Canale di Venezia by Enzo Cacciatore. From morph file. There is a link to it in the description area. To begin, open up your image in Photoshop. Double-click the background layer and name it Color. Now make a copy of the background layer and name it Sketch. Now create a new layer. Name it Paper. Go to Edit Fill and fill it with white. Turn off the eye of the color layer to make it invisible. Move the sketch layer to the top of the layer stack. Choose Filter, Stylize, Find Edges. Press Ctrl plus Shift plus U to desaturate the image. Press the Add and Adjustment Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel, then select Curves. Press the drop-down arrow at the bottom of the Curves box to clip the curve to the layer. Click once in the center of the graph. Drag the line up as I did here. You want the lines to show, but you don't want to have too much black in one area. Select the sketch layer, make the blend mode darken. While the sketch layer is still selected, hold down the Alt key and click the Layer Mask button at the bottom. The drawing isn't visible anymore, only the white paper layer. Select the Brush tool, then select a watercolor brush. I use the Watercolor Loaded Flat Tip from the default brush set. Press your right bracket key 6 times to increase the size to 150. Make sure white is your foreground color and that the black mask thumbnail to the right of the sketch layer thumbnail is selected. Start painting back the drawing. Leave a little space at the border of the photo. You don't have to brush everything in. Concentrate more on the details in the center of the picture. You'll want to leave some small empty areas at the outskirts of the image. We will go back later and touch this up, so just concentrate on painting in the general areas. I've sped up the video here to save some time. Move the color layer to the top of the stack and make it visible and active. Change its blend mode to darken. While the color layer is still selected, hold down the Alt key and click the layer mask at the bottom of the panel. Now only the sketch is visible. Open your brush tool, Choose the wet sponge brush from the default brushes. Change the brush size to 800. I used the right bracket key a number of times to get it to 800. Change the opacity to 30%. Make sure white is your foreground color, and that the black mask thumbnail at the right of the sketch layer thumbnail is active. Make two large strokes in a Z pattern to lay down a sponge wash for the background. Choose a large watercolor brush. I chose watercolor loaded wet flat tip from the default brushes. Change its size to 200. I use the right bracket keys to increase it to 200. Change the opacity to 87%. While the black mask in the color layer is still active and the foreground color is still white, start painting out the color areas. You want this layer to be smaller than the sketch layer, and you should leave some of the sketch layer detail uncolored. Also, a nice touch is to leave an interesting area partially colored, such as the red bricks in the left foreground and the boat and pylons on the right side. It's okay to leave a small white streak or two, as it just makes it look more natural. Once the color area is painted in, go back to the sketch layer black mask and with a white brush, bring out some of the empty areas bordering the color edges. Also, go back to the curves adjustment layer for the sketch and adjust it darker or lighter as needed to bring out the black sketch lines. At this point, we will add a watercolor paper texture to the image. You could use any watercolor or soft paper texture here. I chose to use the maple tea texture on watercolor paper by Shadzi at DeviantArt. The link is in the description area. I think it goes very well with this project. First, make the top layer active. Then choose File, Place Embed, or Place if you have an earlier version of Photoshop. Choose the maple tea texture. And it will be placed on the image. You need to expand it to cover the entire image. Click the check mark or press enter to accept. Change its blend to multiply. Select the layer mask to the right of the color layer thumbnail. Make sure black is your foreground color and the opacity is 100%. The idea here is to simulate sketched-in areas around the outer borders of the image. Work your way around the picture. Try to make the areas look like brush strokes. Select the top layer. Then press Ctrl, Shift, Alt, and the letter E to create a composite layer. Name the layer Composite. Make the top layer active. Then click the FX icon at the bottom of the panel. Choose the Gradient Overlay Style. Click the drop-down on the gradient box. Then choose the little gear icon and choose Photographic Toning. Click OK to accept. Now click the little gear again and choose Large List From the list, we're going to select Sepia Gold. Now change the blend mode to soft light. Click OK to accept. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.